Before the video starts, today's shoutout winner goes to Groovy Kieran. If you guys want a chance to win a shoutout in the next video, drop a like and a comment down below, subscribe with notifications on, and I will pick somebody randomly that will be shouted out in my next video. I hope you guys enjoy. Yo, what's going on guys, Satsuki here, and we have a really juicy, insane, crazy biblical video for today. I can't stress it enough. The news we have for today is absolutely biblical, you know? Now, before I get into it, go grab yourself some oranges, strawberries, pizza, I don't know guys, go grab yourself something to eat, because the drama we have for today's video is beyond the moon, you know? But now, this story is coming from a few former Parallel members, Summit, who is the founder and owner of Parallel, Sora Crude, who is one of the owners and overall leader of Sora, and a few other people. Now yesterday, out of nowhere, about four Parallel members were kicked. A former Parallel Rucker, Bojin, Bruce, and Delusive were all dropped from the team. And after everybody started hearing about this, a lot of people were pissed off at the leaders of Parallel, because they felt like they didn't deserve to get kicked, and you know, something fishy is going on in the Parallel leading staff. Now after Bruce got dropped, he tweeted out saying, "When Offset said, they do anything for clout, I felt that on a personal level." And judging by this tweet, we can only infer that the kicking of these members had something to do with numbers, followers, or subscribers, you know? Also, Bruce made a very long statement regarding this whole situation, and in the statement I'm gonna read to you guys, Bruce claims and goes on to say that the reason why Rucker, Bojin, Delusive, and himself got kicked is because of the lack of viewers they pull, and this is what Bruce had to say. "My response, straight to the point, lacking productivity for months, can't hope they'll turn it around. 20 to 40 viewers isn't the commitment we want from the members of the top tier organization we're wanting to build. 1. Me and Bogan's point of view. We upload videos we take our time on. We don't spam upload Fortnite montages for easy subscribers and views. So yes, our growth might have been a little slow, but we are still growing and getting a good amount of views. Brojin Taj, our introducing to Parallel was done for almost 2 months. Summit told us multiple times it was so good and was already scheduled to go up on a certain day. On upload day, we got ignored all day, the editor included. When we asked Summit when it was going up, he talked in Parallel chat, me, tweets, etc. He was clearly ignoring us. Next day, he makes a group chat with himself, Bojin, Joey, and me, and tells us it's not going up. More info will be in the meeting we are having as a team. We said, alright, no big deal. In the announcement call, everyone was told we are slowing down on montages to switch to content. No personal montages were going up for the time being, unless you have a big audience or people are asking for your video. Again, we said no big deal, it'll go up in due time. The first week, we are told we are switching to content. Me and Bojin bust our butts off for hours trying to make something fun out of what we were doing, because it wasn't fun at all, forcing ourselves to do something we didn't want to do. But we made the best out of it and got the video done. We sucked it up and made the best out of it, no ifs, ands, or buts. Summit gets the drive and says how happy he is we did the video, because he wanted to do it as a team upload months ago. So me and Bojin were hyped we pulled content off. We started talking about more video ideas for the channel. We were trying to get in as many Parallel uploads as we could to help the team, besides the one content video that went up. Fortnite strategy is broken. I don't think any other video has even been attempted besides Bojin and I, and Octo's video idea that we were going to be a part of. So for a commitment to be brought up is complete BS, and Summit knows it, especially saying it about Delusive. Fast forward a few weeks after we give Summit the video, we have no communication at all regarding the video, so I DM Summit and ask about it. He gives a valid reason for it being put on hold, no big deal. Weeks pass again, no communication on the video. Bojin DM'd and got ignored for days, probably a week. I DM him asking if Bojin can go up after 1 year, and he says Doug and him will figure it out. 2 days later, we are kicked? Question mark. How are we in the wrong? We were told two of our videos were gonna go up, then we're told when we're kicked, they aren't good enough. Question mark. Why couldn't we get communication in those quote-unquote weeks? They had the idea of kicking us. Question mark. Instead, we are trying to communicate, and they didn't care because our numbers aren't big enough, as you can tell by what Summit said. And I quote, 20 to 40 viewers isn't enough. It's sad because Summit used to scream and shout how he loves underrated people, and have Coins was released, he completely started changing up. Exilla was kicked because his channel is too small. Parallel hasn't been a quote-unquote family in months. I cannot be more serious when I say this. Most of the members in Parallel feel the exact same way we do, but they won't say anything because Summit's a dictator and he'll flip out or just ignore you. Commitment. Delusive denied FaZe Clan to stay with his friends. GG's only. So holy guys. Delusive literally denied FaZe Clan just so he can stay in Parallel with his friends. If I was Delusive, I would have joined FaZe Clan in a snap of a finger, you know? And the fact that Delusive stayed really shows how loyal he was to Parallel and how loyal he is to his friends. And the fact that the leaders of Parallel still went through with the decision to kick Bruce, Rucker, Bojin, and especially Delusive is just absolutely absurd in my opinion. And you know, Bruce had very good points in this statement. He did say that he had 2 videos ready for the Parallel channel, so he was being productive, and the main reason he strongly believes he got kicked for is because he doesn't have very high numbers. matters. And obviously, guys, there are two sides to every story. I will now share the other side of the story to you guys, which is Parallel Summit's response to this whole situation. And once again, Summit is the founder and owner of Parallel. After Twitter started blowing up, Summit tweeted out saying, "I tried being respectful and letting people part ways on their own, but I guess I have no choice but to put my reasoning out to everyone to see. Since nobody can seem to even attempt to look at a group decision, to drop the people who are dropped from Parallel today. A tweet soon." And now finally, Summit's response to the whole situation. He posted a pretty long statement, and this is what he had to say. "A statement regarding the people we kicked from Parallel today. Please read this thoroughly and attempt to look at the situation as a whole before forming an opinion. Thank you. Today, we decided to drop 4 members today, including Delusive, Rucker, Bojan, and Bruce. It had nothing to do with our dislike for these people. We just felt now was a good time to make the decision we've been sitting on for weeks. Doug and I pleaded with our team, our members, and ourselves to handle the situation professionally and respectfully in hopes that both parties would do the same. Unfortunately, we were not awarded the same courtesy, so here's our reasoning behind our decision-making process. The individuals that were kicked have been lacking productivity for months. We can't just hope that they eventually turn it around when they've had plenty of time to prove themselves worthy of sticking around. Like I said, the decision wasn't personal, it was strictly a business decision, and something we felt needed to be done for the betterment of Parallel. That's all there is to it. There's a lot of unnecessary drama behind the scenes that not only do I want to deal with, it makes the perception of what we built look so chaotic from only one side. We are attempting to get Parallel to the point of being a viable option and career path for whoever wants it to be that. And with a goal like that, hard decisions have to be made. Just firing up a stream to the same 20 to 40 people every day, while that may seem active and productive on the surface, it isn't the commitment we want from our members of the top tier organization we are wanting to build. Making no effort to expand your audience on any other platforms is something we've tried making our members aware is not what we expect. We've had meeting after meeting, and we are sorry if not everyone sees it our way, but these people were aware of our expectations. It's not like this is fun for Doug and I, and it's not like this was a decision we came up an hour ago. We've been working on this for weeks, probably months. We hope that some of the confusion can be cleared up by our statement, at least in part, and people continue to see Parallel for the great things we've done and the great things we have planned ahead." So, you know, Summit basically said that kicking these guys was a very smart business decision, hence why they kicked Rucker, Bruce, Bojan, and Delusive, because they don't pull numbers, and Summit also claims that they weren't being productive. Before we move on, I want to see who made it this far into the video. So if you are hearing this right now, comment down below right now and tell me one thing you want unvaulted in Fortnite. I just want to see who made it this far and who's a real one. But now back to the juicy stuff. And then Sore Crude, the overall leader of Sore, quoted Summit's tweet by saying, "I can't stop laughing reading this." So basically, Sore Crude is saying that Summit's response to all of this isn't really that great, and the reasons for kicking these 4 guys isn't really justified, you know? And just because those 4 guys don't pull that many numbers isn't a valid reason, because they were all being productive and they're all amazing Fortnite players, you know? And then today, Sora Crude dropped all the balls, guys. He tweeted out saying, "Low key, really glad I have this Twitter so I can share these idiotic messages I get 2 months ago." And Crude posted a private DM conversation with himself and Parallel Textra. And as you guys can see on the screen, on April 3rd of 2019, and just a little backstory real quick, around this time, Textra ended up leaving Sora for Parallel, and Sora Crude chose a DM Textra sent to him of when he wanted to leave Sora for Parallel. Textra sent Crude a DM saying, "There is nothing more to talk about. I told you what my decision was, and I respectfully came to you about it. In the end, my contract is virtually useless. It doesn't offer me anything, and by leaving it wouldn't affect you or Sora at all. I know you said that you don't want to drop me, but I don't think that's the truth. If you publicly need to shame me in order to drop me, that's fine. One more thing. What about the other Sora guys? Smax, Louis, Dylan. They constantly preach about wanting to join FaZe with no consequence. I understand that it is FaZe and all, but doesn't that seem kind of backwards? Are you not a stepping stone for FaZe?" Then Crude replied with, "Not really, and I don't need to publicly shame you. What are you even saying?" And in the second screenshot, stuff really hits the fan. On June 26, 2019, June 26 is the day the whole Parallel situation went down, that whole kicking Parallel member situation, and that basically Parallel wants members to pull in numbers now. Well, that same day, Textra DM'd Crude back, and he sent him his own tweet, and the tweet reads, "I'm a strong believer that whoever is meant to be in your life will eventually gravitate back to you, no matter how far away they wander." Now, obviously, Textra wants to join Sora back because he feels like Parallel isn't a family anymore. Bruce even said it in the statement, so by the looks of it, it seems like there are a few members in Parallel who are not happy with the current state of the team. And then Crude replied with a question mark, and Textra said, "That's a good tweet, that's all." And then finally, Textra breaks the ice. He DM'd Crude saying, "I don't know how to start this other than saying I'm sorry, man. Your tweet hit me really hard when I first saw it. Made me realize how fake I was. Made me think of all the friends I lost. I know I effed up. I know what I did was stupid and selfish, and I'm sorry, Crude. I don't expect you to forgive me, but I just wanted to say that you guys were right. I don't expect you to let me in the team, at least easily. I know I have to earn it again. No matter how long it takes, I'm going to try. Thanks, boss. I'm sorry, this is kind of long. I know you are busy. And then the juicy stuff. Four Crude drops all the balls once again, guys. He replied to Textra by saying, "This is cute, but you are never joining back." Holy guys. Textra is blacklisted from Soar. That's absolutely biblical, you know? Then Textra replied to the tweet by saying, "Come on, man." And Crude dropped the balls again, guys. This is like the fourth time Crude dropped the balls. He replied to Textra by saying, "I'll call you a hypocrite now." And he shows another private DM conversation between him and Textra. And it shows, Textra first DM'd Crude by saying, "It was for a long time, but I changed. I found that Parallel suits me better. At least my style for everything." Then Crude replies with, "Huh? Question mark. What does that mean exactly? Don't really have the time to talk about stuff like this right now. We'll speak on the weekend. Good night." And then Textra says, "Good night. If it comes down to it, you can do what you guys did to Dweeby. If you want to call me a hypocrite for wanting to join another team, that's fine." Then Crude says, "What does that even mean? Lamau." Then Textra replies with, "Dropping me, because I've only been in for a month." Then lastly, Crude replies with, "I don't want to drop you. I like you." And there you have it, guys. From the outside perspective, it does seem like some members in Parallel are not happy, and they want to join different teams, and Textra is a prime example of that. He wants to join back Soar, but he is now blacklisted. But yeah, guys, I gave you guys both sides of the story. Let me know whose side you're on. Are you on Parallel side, or are you on Rutgers, Delusive, Bojan, and Soar side? Drop a comment down below right now. Now, me personally, I see it from both sides. I see it from Rutgers, Bruce, Bogan's, and Delusive's perspective, and I also see it from Summit's perspective, because he just wants what's best for his team, you know? And honestly, getting kicked for not pulling high numbers is really messed up in my opinion, because followers, subscribers, and viewers shouldn't even be a factor. It should mainly be how you carry yourself, your personality, and obviously your skill. And also, guys, we don't really know who's telling the truth, and you know, hopefully Parallel can get back on track and stay out of drama, because if you guys remember a couple months ago, Summit actually ended up kicking Coins from the team. And if you guys don't know who Coins is, well, he was also a founder of Parallel, and later down the line, Summit ended up dropping him, and then after Coins got kicked, he joined the Obey Alliance as team captain, and then a couple months later, Obey actually ended up ending. So you know, I feel bad for Coins, and I already made a whole video on that situation. You guys can go watch it if you want, but again, guys, we don't know what side is telling the truth, so I am not picking sides on the story yet. If we get more information on the story, I will keep you guys updated, so be sure you are subscribed with notifications on. And you know, I do feel bad for Bruce, Rucker, Bojan, and Delusive. Hopefully they can join a team soon. They're all really good clip hitters, you know. Maybe they can all join Soar. But that's all the news for today, guys. If you guys happen to enjoy the video, drop a like and a comment. And if you want to be kept updated with everything that happens, make sure to subscribe with notifications on. Okay, peace.